When you've got the Broadway Blue Shirts and a team once known as the Broad Street Bullies, you've got urban warfare. You look for the little battles, the hidden shots. It's when a bitter rivalry can turn a touch ugly. In game number three. The Big Rink in the Big Apple, Madison Square Garden in the heart of Manhattan. They bill it as the world's greatest entertainment center. They'll get a show tonight as the Philadelphia Flyers and New York Rangers bang heads right in the middle of Broadway. You need him. Ron Hextall went into the net for Gar Snow in relief. Gar Snow gave up 5 goals on 10 shots in game number two, and then Ron Hextall came in and did the job, stopped 12 shots for the Philadelphia Flyers. Well, Greg Millen, how about Ron Hextall going in net? He hasn't played much in the 97 playoff.
No, he's not used to being the role of a backup goaltender, if you will, but I spoke with him yesterday. He said he gained a lot of confidence in game two coming in relief for Gar Snow, and he has to use that very early in this building. And here we go. What a building this is. This has got to be the greatest place to play, I'm telling you, Scott.
There come the New York Rangers, the Knights of Manhattan in their white shirts this evening. And you know what? They've taken a lot of injuries, a lot of lineup changes for them. Can they persevere?
Well, it's adversity. Anytime a team has adversity surrounding it, they always seem to find a way to win somehow. And I'm sure that's what Colin Campbell is telling his team in the locker room. You got to find a way, boys.
Philadelphia Flyers are coming onto the ice, and they've been very physical in the series throughout. And Harry Neal, I guess we all expect that that might continue tonight.
I don't think it'll change a bit. The Flyers historically have been a tough team. In game one, they out-muscled the Rangers and won easily. In game two, the Rangers met them physically and won the game 5-4. And one of the beauties of this sport is that often the smallest player on the ice is the biggest. And that was true Sunday afternoon when Wayne Gretzky, with his hat trick, led the Rangers to a 5-4 victory. When you count Wayne's league play and playoff games, he scored 3,082 points. He's an ageless wonder.
Conference deadlock next from New York City.
Thank you, Scott, and hello again, everybody. Well, this building, you know, is going to be alive. Very much alive. And you're going to hear a lot of Ron Hextall tonight. Not quite like that, but the fans here love to get on Ron Hextall. Well, he's in for Philadelphia. They even gave him the razzing in the warm-up. At the other end will be Mike Richter again. Usually 4 goals is enough to win anywhere when Richter is in the net. The Rangers needed 5, remember, in game two to win it. Referee for this game, Bill McCreary, Kevin Collins, and Jerry Gauthier will work the lines. Game three, set to get underway. Lindros against Graves. Lindros won the faceoff. Philadelphia will move it up. Nienema and Lindros getting the zone with a first shot. Kicked out, big rebound from Richter. And he has to make another stop. Penalty coming up against New York right off the bat. Hextall has gone to the bench. I don't think they played 20 seconds. Here's an empty net, but of course, well, that's picked up by Graves. He was hoping that the Philadelphia Flyer player might deflect it in. Redberg trying to bring it back in and did. Put a pass in on the wing. Plant has stopped. It's down the ice again. And a race for it. Eastwood. He got the rebound. Hextall is down, but he couldn't hang on to it. What a rush by Eastwood. killing the last part of the penalty. 30 seconds remain on it. So far, so good for New York. Graves missed it, but the puck goes down the ice anyway, and the Ranger player hurt is Chernander.
He was knocked into the boards as the puck was shot down the length of the rink, and it hasn't got up. The Rangers did a great job killing the penalty. Klatt was the guy that hit Chernander. Feels as he's going to the Ranger dressing room.
Both coaches are aware that this has already started out to be a very physical service series, and they see no reason why it won't continue tonight here in Madison Square Garden.
It's an easy one to call, though.
Flyers are coming in, led by Lindros. Shot it in wide, and the Flyers are in on it. Messier trying to find it off the boards, does, and the Rangers will skate out. Second to center ice with a long shot, and that's wide. The penalty is over now. Akins is out of the box, totally away from the puck. Near center ice, Lindros. He'll be on a good deal of this game, to be sure. Desjardins takes it behind the net. Lindros had to scoop it quickly, got it up to Klatt. The Flyers are on the move. They've been coming at the Rangers. Nice save. Left pad by Richter. And it's out of the zone again. Oh. Lindros again going after it in there. Takes a bump. Shakes it off and gets in front of the net. Turns. And the weak shot. And again, Samuelson stayed right with 88 and held him up. Hence, a weak shot. Got it back to Coffey. In there, the lip of the crease. Lindros around the net. And a great save by Richter. Another long shot doesn't reach him. And the Rangers get out. Messier bouncing one in wide of the net. The crowd buzzing. Lindros thought he had scored. Richter made a sensational save. He'll be tested again as the Flyers shoot it in. Coffey missed the pass, though. There's a penalty behind the play. The Philadelphia player, LeClaire, is on the ice, but nobody has moved. It looks like a Ranger penalty. It is a Ranger penalty. Bookaboom.
Well, that was a big-time hit. It doesn't look like it's a goal. That's what all these goal judges say, but I think it was in the net.
They're sure taking some time. You would think they have looked at all possible angles. It's a goal. Yes, it is. Philadelphia leads 1-0.
It just gets over the line right above Richter's glove, right there. Went off the Ranger player's stick.
Fans are now just catching on that their team is down to Philadelphia. It appeared Richter made a sensational save. But as you saw, the puck was in. Samuelson is decked to center ice. Dykhouse threw it around the boards. Lister kept it in, took a shot. Graves got in front and didn't know he had the puck in behind him. More bodies fly. 1-0 Philadelphia. Gets it back to the blue line. Niedema shot. He missed. Right in front. And the shot off the shoulder of Richter and hit the side of the net. They get it back out front again. Good pressure by LeClaire of the Flyers now. Eastwood can't stop him. LeClaire got it back. Simona shot, scores! Well, that's pressure for you. The Flyers were flying. And they lead 2-0. Philadelphia 11. And the two goals, Leach coming up now. Leach passed back to Messier. Got one shot and gave it to Leach. Leach the other side, back to Leach. The pass gets into Gretzky and his shot is blocked by Therrien. Dykhouse is back. Rangers jam at it in front of the net. They don't get it out. One long shot is blocked. Rangers keep it in. They're fighting back. Dykhouse chopped it away from the side of the net where Cornell was waiting for it. Stopped at the line and kept in, but now Philadelphia pick it up and get it to center, remaining in the penalty. 2-0 Philadelphia. That's Robitaille. Got it back to Gretzky. To Tikkanen. Back to Gretzky on a skate. Gretzky centered it. And Hextall comes up with his first big save. And lost lost control. And the Rangers, with 15 seconds left, come up over center. Messier finds a little room, not much, along the boards. And he's caught, finally. Lindros the other way. Gets it over the line. Zubras put it back to him. But he's covered by this time by the Ranger player, Graves, who skated back with him. And as Messier and Tikkanen skated away to center, the buzzer ends the period. Flyers, well, the only scoring plays are up 2-0. They're down at home here in game three. And they move it up again quickly. To center is LeClaire. Shoots it into the far side. Samuelson takes over. Gives it to Bukaboom. LeClaire comes rushing in on him. Not for long. Coffey got back though to pick it up, and then he lost it again. Leach trying to get in there. Here's a shot. And that's stopped. Robitaille one-timed it. And Hextall was on the post in the right spot. And he made a fine save. And down the ice, and Hextall is leaving the net again. Turned and shot it just wide of his own net. Churla. Penalty coming up against Philadelphia. Churla is battling away on the boards. And now the play whistle dead. And good work by Churla along the boards. There's a Philadelphia penalty. This time he can't get it by Graves. Rangers pass it around. A long shot. Big rebound there. And Hextall finds it. He's down. And the puck bounced through his pads, but he saw it in time. So the two-period total up to now, 15-10 for Philadelphia. Rangers on the attack. In close. Robitaille shot deflected. Somebody getting a stick in front of these shots at both ends now. And a lot of the shots, the Flyers are all back there waiting for it. Svoboda gets it up to Renberg. He leaves it. Howardchuk coming around the net. Trying to jam it in. There's a loose puck there. And Richter couldn't get up. Gretzky rescued the puck and skated up across the line. Trying to shoot it into the far side. All races in. With Robitaille and Messier. And the shot deflected up over the crossbar. Rangers did come close on that rush. 25 seconds left in the power play. Messier coming in again. Jamming on the brakes. Put it back into the slot. Shot again off the arm of Hextall. He's solid in there. Penalty almost done. The Rangers look for one. Rangers need one. Philadelphia, get it out of the zone. Flyers control the faceoff. Coffey, quick pass in front of his own net. Zubras whacked to the center. Another Ranger down on the ice.
Philadelphia penalty, Bob. Akins is down. The Ranger trainer slipping the rubber glove on before he has a look at him. There's a penalty. I don't know whether it's a 2 or a 4 or a 5.
Play had gone to center. It was cleared inside the Ranger line.
He's pulling his teeth out of his mouth there. It's chipped off. Let's have a look at it right there. Therrien. Sticks him right in the face. And it looks like it's a 5-minute penalty. It's Michel Petit. There it is right there. Eakin slashed him. And then Petit comes back and gives him the stick. Knocked a couple of teeth, you could see.
CA near the line. Had to poke it to the corner. And the Flyers can't get it out this time. Shot right in there for Tikkanen. He went high on the short side and hit the side of the net. Back to Lipster. Another shot into the corner. It's centered. Comes to Leach on the other point. Leach goes in with a great job done by Philadelphia here. They're outside. No room. Lipster played it ahead. Now in the slot. Leach spinning around. No shot. Lipster coming up. Throwing it in. It's deflected again. And cleared to the corner. Keep it in. Still on the power play. Back for the line. And Leach drives it high onto the glass. shot. It'll come to Lidster. His shot into the crowd. Off a stick. And a minute 18 left in the second, minor penalty against Petit. On the backhand and couldn't get a shot. Now again, a shot this time. Again blocked in front of the net. Gretzky shot. Big save by Hexall. And Gretzky couldn't reach it before Lindros slapped it away. And down the ice. And the buzzer goes to end the second period. The Rangers handle the puck well inside the line. Great passing, however, all outside. Hextall was sharp. Still 2-0 Philadelphia. He's getting ready to go to work. He's had two shots on goal in the game. So is Messier. The Rangers, of course, are looking to these two to get some scoring they needed, because Lindros and Svoboda are the only two goal scorers in this game, both coming in the first period. Now to start the third, it'll be a power play of 1:06 for the Rangers. The assistant coach of the Rangers, Dick Todd, visited with Scott.
Dick, you appear to have an opportunity here with the man advantage to start the third period of play. Momentum was in your favor to end the second.
We had some great chances in that second period. A couple guys ran alone, and we just didn't capitalize. You got to give some credit to Ron Axel. He made some big saves that period, and if we can get something on this power play, we'll be right back in the game here.
Difficult for you to fill those holes? Are you juggling lines all night?
Well, it is a problem. You can obviously see that we've had to make a lot of alterations, both on defense and up front, with the number of changes we have in the lineup.
The 1:06 I mentioned, the power play remaining for New York because of Petit. He drew 4 minutes in that second period. That is what's left. And the Flyers send the Rangers back. Tikkanen, Messier, Gretzky. Driver carries it in. Dropped it in there neatly. Messier's right in there. Can't get a shot full. Tikkanen near the blue line. Quick pass ahead, banking that off the boards. Cortnell threw it down the line. Cortnell in the slot near the blue line. Decides to skate in a bit before shooting. Big rebound at the side of the net. It is a pass back to Tikkanen. Just kept it in. Fired one into Gretzky. Out front, score! Cortnell scoring for New York. They're back in it.
Will they go upstairs on this one, Bob? Mark Messier was very close to the crease when Cortnell put that puck in. And this is a recording. They are going upstairs after this goal.
Dynamite, is it not? Here's the play, and keep your eye on the crease.
To the right of Hextall is Messier in it. No,
clean,
he's not.
Clean, baby. Clean.
Russ Cortnell. He was brought in by Neil Smith with Essatikin late in the season. Cortnell has got 2 goals, 3 assists for 5 points in his last 7 games. And he deposits this puck neatly in the corner of the net on a lovely pass from you-know-who. And you can see Messi off to the right of Hextall was not in the goal crease. And the Rangers are back in the game, and so are the fans.
Power play goal by Cortnell, 43 seconds into the period. Set up by Tikkanen and Gretzky, and the crowd now has finally arrived for this hockey game. 18,200 of them, a sellout at this great building in New York City. Dykhouse coming back. 2-1 now, Philadelphia. Starts to play. Coffee up to Lindros. Lindros trying to step in. And they didn't hear the whistle behind the play. A penalty being called. A slash on somebody. And it's going to be a penalty against New York. A big penalty kill for the Rangers here. The crowd just getting into the game. Now Philadelphia with a man advantage. Nienema at the blue line. Started the play. Gets right in front. Loose puck, and Flyers on this one. McCreary is already headed for the telephone.
If there's more than three guys in the offensive zone, they're going upstairs, and here we go again. The phone bill for the NHL has risen dramatically. And let's have a look and see if we can tell you before McCreary tells us whether this goal counts.
Uh-oh.
Oh, that's a close one.
Uh-oh.
That may not count.
LeClair had the right skate there. Now, whether he jerked it back out before the puck came in, and then the left skate came in. And as Harry says, these are our judges up there. They'll let us know before the crowd knows.
Now watch LeClair. He's going to come in right here. Boy, I think his foot was in there. I say that's no goal.
They're going to wipe that out. Listen to this, folks.
When in the National Hockey League have you heard a goal waved off with a more enthusiastic cheer than a goal scored by the home team?
What a turn of events here in the third period. First of all, on a power play, Cortnell scored in 43 seconds. On the move, Ben Lindros going after it in the corner, looking around for it. Nienema goes rink wide with a pass. Hawerchuk shot blocked. Rangers line up in front of Richter, their goaltender. And the puck bounces out over the line. 30 seconds left of the penalty. The Rangers dump it in over the glass, though, into the crowd. And the faceoff is going to be outside the blue line. These fans are humming now. They're on their feet again.
Well, if you believe hometown fans can energize the home team, then the New York Rangers have a chance as they score the goal. And they
throwing it ahead. The speedy Cortnell is up there again. Pass is in behind. Robitaille shot on the short side, and Hextall hangs onto it. Flyers are leading now by one. Messier battles for it behind the Philadelphia net. Robitaille and Cortnell, and the puck comes back near the blue line. Philadelphia moving up smartly. Otto dumped it in. That pass too far for Hodine. Robitaille takes his time up for the Ranger captain at center. And Robitaille gets in there. Fired one at the crease. They score! One at the crease. They score!
And they played the Rangers in the playoffs, and he was 0-3 with
with an unimpressive 6.08 goals against average. And the fans are trying their best to remind him of that horrific playoff series. But Hextall's a little bigger than most fans think.
Big line for New York on again. Gretzky with Tikkanen. And they move it in. Dubé is on that right side with Gretzky now. He's back at center. And the pass comes to him. Weak backhander, though. He fights for it again. And the Flyers hanging on. Get it out. Nearing the six-minute mark. Period number three, a 2-2 tie now. Here in Zubrus. Dykhouse shot. Deflected in front of Richter. Wide of the net. The Rangers can't get it out. Here's a chance. Lindros scores! Lindros blasts a high shot to the glove side of Richter. And the Philadelphia Flyers are ahead again. 3-2. What a wicked shot by Lindros.
Unstoppable. The Rangers looked like they were going to get out of their own end without any trouble coming up the right wing. But turned the puck over. And it ended up on the stick of Erik Lindros. And here's what I'm talking about right here. It's like Samuelsson was going to get it out. But it bumped back to
the blue line. Niedermann moving up. Stopped by Richter. Rebound is cleared to the corner. Raffle on the boards and Coffey stopped it. Nienema, another shot. This time Richter decides he'll try to hang on to it. And he does that. Penalty just about done. There comes Tikkanen. The penalty over. They kill it off. A big kill. It's Gretzky coming up there, taking it off the boards back to the line of Lidstrom. Is in front. Penalty just about done. And the Rangers kill it off and get going. Up comes Courtnell. And the shot, a weak one from Samuelsson. He stumbled at the far side. Loose puck in front. He scores!
Huge one here to tie the game with 5:39 to go. Niedermann overskated the puck. Gretzky cruising in, turned a pass from Courtnell and tied the hockey game.
Gretzky the goal. Courtnell drawing an assist. And it's tied again. 3-3. Flyers attacking goal. Center. Knocked down at center ice. Fires 2-on-1. Klett deals it off. Comes in. Scores! Klett on a 2-on-1. And the Philadelphia Flyers are back in front. 4-3. The time of the goal is 16:52. Hextall gives it away. Two-goal lead for Philadelphia now. Icing called against the Flyers. Brindamore's goal, his eighth of the playoffs. That's Graves trying to work his way in. Doesn't get too far. Under 2 minutes left. Samuelsson gave it away. Lindros is up. Oh! Samuelsson took his man at center ice. LeClair and hit him hard. Rangers attacking. Long shot. Save.
Brind'Amour makes a great play here. He's got to lay that puck down on this bad ice. He does that. Then he comes up with a move to the right and over to the left. And then sticks it up over a sprawling Richter. A nifty move by a fine player.
He did have to sit it down, too.
Yes, he did.
Perfect play by Brind'Amour. And that's insurance for Philadelphia. Platt had the go-ahead goal on a break, a two-on-one break. He and Podine at 14:59. And Brind'Amour at 16:52. Just a little under 2 minutes later. And a minute 10 left as they line up inside the Philadelphia line. Messier won the draw, but Driver couldn't stop it. And it came out. Driver's pass to Tikkanen. 1 minute left. Puck loose in center, and Gretzky stopped that. Threw it over to Driver. He knocked it in. The Ranger net is empty. Flyers just trying to cover now and hang on with 50 seconds left. They'll take a 2-1 lead in the series if they can hang on. They're going to clear this one out. Bouncing it down the ice. Messier has to hurry. Lindros got in front of him. And for sure, that will do it. It is 6-3 Philadelphia. Lindros with his third of the game. The Rangers and the Flyers.
Flyers go home by bus, Bob, right after the game. We'll practice Wednesday and Thursday in Philadelphia. Come in here Thursday night for the game Friday.
So this one is done. Philadelphia getting two goals in the first. Appeared to be in complete control. No scoring in the second. Cortnell got two goals. To start the third period and a brand new game developed. But late in this third, Philadelphia on goals by Klatt, Brind'Amour, and Lindros. And that opens up a 6-3 lead.
Well, Hextall seemed to falter a little bit in the first 4 or 5 minutes of the third period, but recovered and made some big stops. And he has been a fine pinch hitter for Terry Murray, who elected to go the first, most of the first two rounds with Gard Snow. 7 goals scored here in the third period. It was 2-0 Flyers after two.
Rangers win the draw. Philadelphia. Desjardins to the corner to pick it up. Zubras just tipped it away before he hit center. And this game is in the books as the Flyers have defeated the New York Rangers 6-3. And they now take a 2-1 lead in this Eastern Conference Final.
Got a little problem here. Podine trying to get out of the Ranger zone. Got tangled up with some players. Nothing much happened. The referee and the linesman separate them quickly. And Terry Murray's team takes a 2-1 lead in the conference final.
Final shots 28-25. In favor of the Rangers. And the win to the Flyers 6-3.
Philadelphia Flyer victory over the New York Rangers in Game 3 of the Eastern Conference Final. The first star, Eric Lindros, he had his first playoff career hat-trick. The second star, Rod Brind'Amour, finished the scoring for the Flyers. And the third star, Russ Carter.